list here concerning agenda management software. I'm going to ask Paige to give you some information on this. Many of you know that we have discussed maybe 2 years or more about the idea of moving to a paperless agenda. And this is part of that process or discussion. Paige, go ahead.
Where are we?
Under agenda management. Commissioner Ornstein, do you want to start?
Go ahead, I yield to you because I don't know the details of the civic clerk stuff.
Okay. As you all know, our website, now the development of that and the content and that entire process has been working really well. We get a lot of traffic, we get a lot of compliments from citizens. It's not very often that we have a hiccup. Any kind of technology, we'll have one every now and then, but when we do, we've got support with Civic Plus, and they get those things corrected right away. We are now, this year, at the point in our contract, if you remember when we approved that, that after 4 years, they would do a refresh of the site. One of the things that's most important to a website is to make sure that it looks current, that the content is current, that, you know, people don't feel like they're going to the same thing every time. And this site is built so that we can change our content but not the design in-house. So that's one of the additional flexibilities of that. So Sabrina and I have already started working on the timeline to redevelop the website. So you will see much later in the year, probably around the holidays. I think right now we're shooting for November, because our meetings actually start with them in May, to begin that process. With that, we'll also have a new mobile app. In talking to them about that, we found a new module that they have developed that's called Civic Clerk. So we would have the same account representative if you all decide to move forward with this. We're still dealing with one vendor. They still have payment options that don't cost us any additional money. And if you turn to page 2, there's an executive summary there about this product. But basically, it takes the materials and the information, the function, the efficiency related to the process that we use internally to develop an agenda packet. Also, what the citizens see externally, and then what you all experience as part of that process, to the next level. With this, we will totally be off the books. No more making copies. No more Mr. Pritchard having to sign off on sheets and us, you know, sometimes being held up if we don't have them ready when he's in office and we need to wait for him to come back. He will be able to do all of that from a smartphone if he chooses, as far as the approval of the items. We have different levels that we can publish the agenda to. So we can have a level that we publish to the citizens. We have a level that we would publish to you all as commissioners. Also, within your view and your vision of that, I know one of the complaints that we've heard in the past is, well, I like to get my book and I like to make notes. Well, this has an option for you to be able to make those notes within the software, and they will only be viewed by you. And you can also search them later. So, for instance, if we're at the end of the year and you want to know everything that we've looked at related to an ordinance or animal control or purchasing or Mounds County Fire Rescue, you can put in a keyword and search that. The citizens will have the same functionality. So if there's something coming up on the agenda that they're interested in and they want to look at the last time that the commission discussed this or looked at this, they can put in that keyword as well, and it will go back and search not only prior agendas and those materials, but our minutes as well. So it's an easy tool for them to be able to keep track of the items that they're interested in. As I said, everything's in electronic internally for us on the back end, so it'll be quicker for the department heads as well. Also, if you just like the paper and that's what you want, at the end of it, you can hit print and print out every bit of it if you would rather do that. I know some of you try to manage those old materials now by giving us the notebooks back, but you like to keep what was in your packet, so you've got binders somewhere, stacks somewhere of those materials. Again, this is makes it all electronically. You can pull it from an iPad, any other type of tablet, a laptop, or even your phone to be able to go back with that. we can publish items directly to social media. It also allows for a meeting management, if you all chose to do that within the meeting. And this is really something that's probably more attractive to larger local governments, but the meeting management would allow us to record the votes on the screen, like you've seen in the General Assembly has that big long list. We could actually do that if you like. One of the things that's very convenient for me is the process that I would go through is you all are making motions and seconds and voting on things. There's a click system there that allows the minutes to begin to generate. So it will cut down on my time and Sabrina's time on the back end as well. Pricing is based on population with Civic Plus. So I think we're looking at the total product for the hosting and all of the storage and everything is around, let's see, it's in the back, the very, very back. I think we would be looking at either an upfront payment of just over $17,000, or we could break it down into 3 years at $13,200. Based on the time that it takes us, and the storage long term of all of the paper and all those things, I think that it's money well spent. Do you have any questions?
So this will be saving?
Yes. Yes, it will.
Money.
Yes.
How will it be saving?
So if you look at, if you talk about the time that it takes department heads to put together something on paper and they go through the draft and their staff, and then finally get to Mr. Pritchard. So
those department heads can do other things while they're not bogged down?
Sure. Or they also, if, say for instance, that Danny, you know, Danny has several contracts that I know you all feel like that there's like three meetings that all you're doing is approving 911 Motorola contracts over and over again. The reason that they stack up that way is because of the dates that they expire. But if Danny's got all those together, for instance, in March, and they're going to hit June, July, and August, he can go ahead and put those in ahead of time into the system for June, July, and August. Mr. Pritchard can go ahead and get that approved. It goes straight into the agenda process. We're done. No one's having to go back and, you know, reprint a cover sheet or any of that stuff. We also have separate storage that we use for instance, the contracts after they're executed, after everything's signed, because we have to maintain those, everything goes right back into the system. So instead of us having multiple databases and filing cabinets for copies and all of those things, then everything goes in here. We probably spend around $3,000 a year on the paper and the books and the tabs and all that, that just to put these together, even as much as we try to recycle. So there's an actual savings there right off the bat.
So it can be used up to 7 boards?
Yes. So also it can be used for things like this. We could put every bit of this into the system next year for the retreat and not have these binders. Now, where we want to get into, we want to be a little bit careful as far as additional boards go. There's some legal liability with that hosting and when things are published and how and all that. So we want to make sure that we don't get ourselves into that through the sharing process. But there is some flexibility there.
Are we going to need more than this?
It may be a little small for you to just try to go through a meeting on your phone, but you can certainly do it with a laptop. There's some additional things that we've been working on with the Regional Commission to make available to you all. So I think probably a tablet would be the recommended viewing for it. But there's other things that we could put on that tablet that I think would be great for you guys to have at your fingertips when you're meeting with citizens.
Well, I don't have any problem with it whatsoever. I think having a tablet or electronic device of some sort that would allow you to view it, I mean, just from a conservation standpoint, all the paper and everything that's generated would be worth doing this just from that standpoint. And again, for those that still want to look at a hard copy, then, you know, as you said, the print availability is there, it's there, but it doesn't mean that everybody's getting it. It is an age and time where we're we're moving more and more and more to technology. This is something that we probably, that we have had some level of discussion on, sometimes maybe just skim over it for the last 4 or 5 years. And so I think that it's a good tool. I think it's something certainly because it's a software company that we're already utilizing, is that it will work without any complications there. So I would encourage you to take a look at the information and ask any questions of Paige that you may want to ask about it. But I think it's a direction that eventually, I mean, at some point in time, we want to move to. I know from my standpoint, I'd just soon be viewing it on a tablet and saving all the paper. Yeah, I mean, each and one of you know how it works, you know, just in an effort to save from the standpoint of the books. You know, we pull out the information that our notes and stuff, I do, that's how I do it, stuff that I may have made on it, and then give the whole book back to Sabrina. I started out trying to save the whole, everything in here. Miss Evans said, don't do that, you know, save your summary. Well, and she's right, you know, if you just use the summary, then that gives you that basis. But the biggest feature I like out of all of it is that there's a lot of times that there may be some documentation that we're 3-4 meetings down the road, or even a year down the road, and I said, you know, I'd like to kind of see what the thoughts were and how we got to here. And you can do that search, go back and pull up those meetings where that was discussed earlier, and decisions were made, and then you get a better picture as a whole. So it kind of helps your memory a little bit by being able to go back and just really review what, maybe not necessarily what you thought somebody said or what you thought a decision was, but then you can go back and verify that that was actually what your decision was.
You mentioned an app for citizens, and that's not part of this.
No, that's separate. That's part of the website.
Aaron's working on something, or was, isn't that right, Joe? How far along is that?
The last conversation he and I had, frankly, he's been pretty well tied up on this court software. So it's not as far along as I would like it to be. But once we got this update, it may be that, well, we got an option. We can go either way, but I think this is probably going to be cheaper than the software he's looking at. That's what I believe. But I won't know that until a little closer to the budget.
I think we're way overdue for this. I think we need to make this a priority. Not rush through it to make a decision, but I don't think we kick the can down the road any longer on it. I think we need to do our due diligence and listen to Paige and make sure that it meets our expectations, and as soon as possible try to get something in.
If I heard you correctly, through the process right now, we could be at this point next year to where we wouldn't be using it.
I think that we can incorporate this into our plan with the website redesign, so that probably by 1-1, we're up and running.
Okay.
If you all,
that's what
you
I would
know,
encourage,
to do that
you move in that, direction, then if it can happen, it happens.
What kind of training is going to be involved? Using something like this for me and Doris.
Very, very little. And we can make it through it. Yeah.
Me and Joyce.
It's really designed to probably be no more complicated than the view that you would have with Facebook. It's very simple, and Sabrina will be trained by them, and then we can do individual trainings, or we can do a group training with all of you all. But I didn't see it overly complicated. And a lot of what we've looked at has been, or there was a limit on the views, or you didn't have the option to put in those notes. If there was a question that you wanted to ask during the meeting about a particular item, you were still going to have a piece of paper somewhere and have that with you, whereas all this goes into the system. You've got it all there to go back and access whenever you want. The other great thing is that when sometimes y'all leave town and we don't have the books ready, you're going to come flying back in on Monday morning to the work session and you've not had time to look at everything. This, once we publish it for your view, you can access it from, you know, wherever you are. So there's not not that inconvenience. It's not that we don't love to see y'all, but I know sometimes you come in after hours and have to make that trip back down. So this puts it at your fingertips.
Do we know what the investment cost for the hardware is at this point?
No additional. They host everything. So we don't have a hardware.
I'm talking about the tablets or the
iPads. The tablets are running around $1,000 with the bulk pricing. They're running around $1,000.
But there's other benefits to that, too. I mean, just think about, you know, the possibilities are endless with that. Just having your district map, just having the data that she's talking about that's being processed through the RDC now, being able to fire stations, to track, you know, all that data now can be in one device in front of us at any given moment. I mean, I just, I don't know, that excites me. I mean, I'm kind of the techie
guy. You're a geek. You're the head geek.
I'm a geek. But I mean, it's the 21st century. I mean,
I know that you guys are great to, you know, absorb that cost into, you know, your own budgets, because I see a lot of you taking your personal laptop or your personal tablet and using that, you know, but you're sitting down with people all over the community, and not that they don't expect access to you, but you also have a personal life as well. And I think that sometimes it's nice to be able to sit down in front of people, show them the county's business on something that, you know, your children or, you know, whoever's faces don't immediately pop up on. I mean, there's not all that information that you want to share with everyone. And so also, because of the open records laws, anything that you're maintaining that is your county business on your personal electronic devices makes your personal electronic devices subject to open records. So again, it's just good business to have that division between your work life and your personal life.
Well, I think it's a great tool, and I think it's a great tool for the commissioners, again, was touched on. You can utilize, I mean, when you're talking with civic groups or you're talking with individual citizens, the information that will be available to you is right there. And so I think
how to access.
I think it would be a huge asset.
We'll have pictures on your home screen.
Are you on Facebook?
I mean, just that demographic, this information that we got earlier this morning, you could have it on there. And anytime that anyone wanted to talk to you about it, so here are the numbers. You know, I think it's just really, rather than talking in generalization, it will allow you to get more down into the weeds as far as factual information.
If this becomes reality, I want you to download what you got in here on Mac.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yeah.
Probably still would have operator errors.
Can I help?
That's a compliment. I thought it was impressive, though, when I asked Paige a few months ago about this, and said, you know, every retreat I've brought up something about, you know, technology or how are we ever going to get there, whatever. You know, she had way ahead of me, as she always is with all of us, and had already found this and researching it and trying to come up with a proposal. And I trust her guidance and advice on this. Like I said, I'm excited about it, and I don't want us to, oh, well, you know, back and forth. And if we prove it out and we think it's going to work, then let's move on.
Well, we feel really good about this platform because, as I said initially, we've had such good service from our web provider. Also, with all the other platforms that we've looked at, just knowing what I know a little bit about you all individually and your preferences and what you like to look at and how, every single one before I found, well, I don't know that this is exactly what Commissioner Ornstein is looking at, or I don't know that Commissioner Evans is going to find this very user-friendly. This one, I feel as comfortable as I can be that, you know, based on our experiences of how you all like to receive information and go through that, but this is something that everybody will enjoy.
Great.
Okay.
Thank you.
Y'all are welcome. We can move on, or are you all ready to eat? Got hungry, or?
Nah, it's 11:11.
Okay.